Hey, Curler veterans or newcomers, it's Catherine and
Danny,
and we are gonna show you how to do the curlers. Okay, so we start off with splitting the hair and combing it out. You will have to shower before, but we were just gonna put them in for night, so we didn't shower. So you're gonna take the front section and you're gonna take a curler. This is a very important part because it has to be in the center, and you're going to use the Pantene Curl. It's at Target. This is what it looked like last year. So you're going to take it, you're going to spray the piece of hair you grabbed from the front center, and you're going to take the curler and curl it all the way down your hair. You got to roll it backwards away from your face, because that otherwise it will turn out bad and a disaster, and your bump will be a mess, and you do not want that, okay? Okay, so you're gonna basically do that for the rest of your head all the way down. So basically a straight line down the center of your head. And then, so right here, I'm taking the front bar and pinning it back to the second curler that's right behind that, so you don't get a line in the front of your bump, which can cause your bump to split, which you don't want that. That's bad. That's a no-no. And then we're going to continue going all the way back. Yeah. Make sure your hair isn't sopping wet when you put it in. Make sure it's just damp. Otherwise, it won't go very well. This is what it's going to look like when it's all done. And now we're going to start on the sides, and we're going to be using the mousse, because some people use mousse, some people use spray, so we're going to show both. So you're going to take the mousse, you're going to spray about that size. Much, and about, yeah, that Danny just showed, about that much mousse. You're going to put it in the hair, and you're basically going to do the same thing that you did with the spray, except you're going to be doing it with mousse. So you're going to curl it the same way. You're going to curl it under, so it's going to be so under the curl, so you're going to curl it towards your head, but don't curl it like up, if that makes sense. You'll see it in a second, hopefully.
Basically what she's trying to say is make sure the curler is facing directly outwards instead of sideways.
Yeah. Okay, so now once you got some mousse in the hair, you're gonna curl it under, not outward, so like down, like how I'm showing it in the video. Okay, so you're gonna repeat the whole thing all the way on both sides of your hair. And these don't have to be in rows, just get it where you can, because it doesn't matter, because it's all gonna be in one giant curly blob at the end. So here I'm starting to use green curlers on Danny's hair. That's part of the reason, because we didn't have enough pink curlers, which you want the 1-inch pink curlers, where you can find at Sally's Beauty Store. I know that you can order them on Amazon, but I'm going to be starting to use green curlers.
Because if you have, let's say you have thicker hair and more hair, I would use the pink curlers just to kind of be more time saving. But if you have more thin hair, I would use the green ones, because they're easier to curl with when you have thin hair.
And also if it's like finer and it falls more, the tighter the curl, the more it will stay.
Mm-hmm. Also, make sure when you're curling the hair, make sure to go directly out from the scalp like she's doing right here, and not directly down from the hair like it falls, because if you do that, then it won't stay directly onto the hair and the roots won't curl.
Okay, so here I'm just finishing up the last curler. And now after this, you're going to be doing your bandana, but that's it for curling the hair. So the hardest part is done. So if you have any questions, ask me. There's two different ways to do a bandana. This is the first way. It's the more simple way, I would say, but it doesn't hold as much curlers in. So you're going to take it, you're going to fold it in half, and you're basically going to roll it all the way down to the end. When you have it all rolled, you're going to take it and wrap it around your hair. This is basically just to keep the front curlers from falling out or getting more loose, because the bottom curlers and I think the top ones are kind of more important to keep tight in the front ones, because you can always like hide the ones in between, but like the front ones are like the ones where you're like, if they're flat, they're flat. You can't really do much about it. So most girls do this one, but I like to do the one I'm about to show you. So you're going to take the bandana, you're going to fold it kind of in a third, because you're going to wrap it in your whole head. So it's basically based on your head size. So if you have a big head, you're going to want more fabric.
Like me.
And you're going to want less fabric if you have a smaller head. So you're basically going to tie it like you did the first, like how you would the first one. But you could kind of see how the tail is out. So you're going to take that tail and you're going to pull it all the way up over all the curlers. And so then this is just going to hold all of them. But if your hair is wet, it's going to not dry that well. And then you're going to take it once you get it all the way through all your hair, and you're going to tie it with the rest of it. I think I really like the style because it makes me look like a grandma, and I'm embracing my inner mom.
I look like a crazy cat.
Yeah. So basically, you're going to take the wings, because they'll be wings when you fold it. You're going to tuck those in, and you're going to have your front curler out, basically. And now we're on to taking them out. Oh, my Jesus. Okay, so you're going to take the curler out. You're going to roll it.
Start from bottom.
Yes, because you're not going to want to rip it out. That's not going to work. You're going to split it in half, and you're going to back comb the top inch or two of the section. Otherwise, it's going to be a poopy mess, and ain't nobody want that in life. You're going to do that from bottom to top throughout your whole head, and once you get to the top, just leave in the front two curlers in the center, so of your mohawk, and you're going to use those for the bump. You'll find us chasing the sun. I'm never down. Lying here staring up and you're looking down. I'm never down. Live forever, forever with you around. We've only just begun. Hypnotized by drums until forever comes. You'll find us chasing the sun. They said this day wouldn't come. We refuse to run. We've only just begun. You'll find us chasing the sun. The sun, the sun, the sun. Yay, now we're at the fun part. We're at the bump. Yay, so much fun. Don't be afraid to hurt the person you're doing it. They're gonna have to get used to their hair getting pulled. So basically what I do is I take the curler out, the second one, I'm gonna split that in half, and I'm gonna back comb basically the whole thing. I'm gonna do it to the other section. Then I'm gonna take that front curl, and I'm gonna do it with the back half of it, and you're gonna keep that front part that Danny was just holding there, because otherwise your bump is gonna look like a rat's nest. You don't really want that. So what I'm doing right here is I'm pushing it forward and bobby pinning it. So here I'm taking the little baby hairs from the side and pinning it back also, because it just makes it look more like it's one thing instead of like you can see where your part is. So that's what I do. People do it all different ways. But so here's if you have a piece that isn't curled that's in the center. So you're basically gonna take it, you're gonna put it up, and you're gonna bobby pin it in. So there you go, it's gonna be bobby pinned, and then it just kind of matches with your normal hair. Now we're all done! Yay! So now you have some beautiful curled hair. Hopefully you guys have a good season and just have fun!
Practice curlers over the summer!